We'll see how that audio goes now.
Hello, internet. Can you hear me?
Did they answer you, Suz?
No, I'm not. I can. The people here can hear me, but I don't know if the internet can.
So in the warm-up phase, a couple of minutes to go until Derby. Technical problems being straightened out as we speak. Now we're making Jess run.
Certainly are. We'd like to take a moment to thank our sponsors. Welcome to Thornbury, Nelson Alexander, and a big shout out to Eurus. We miss you.
This game proudly brought to you by Eurus. We miss you.
Hello, internet. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Suz.
Listen to that, people. We are live on the internet.
Hello from Bosnia and Herzegovina. Oh, no, that's Eurovision.
That's Eurovision. Yeah. Welcome to this first live stream of our Friday night tights games between the Northside Rollers home teams, the Sisters of Anarchy and the Pulp Vixens.
Let's have a read through the team, Suz. Skating in the purple and white today for the Pulp Vixens, Briannosaurus Rex, Flustered Tart, Grenade O'Connor, Miss Ree, Bella, Mad Pixie, Mad Scientist, Venus Thighslap, KO and Cupquakes. Acker's looking after those guys on the bench tonight, I understand. And in the red and black, the Sisters of Anarchy, we've got X, Hangry Anderson, Fizzgig, Mary Boppins, Catitude Problem, Steel Thunder, Odd Sock Fitz, Smackrobat, and Bumpy Skate Princess. Oh my glob. Ably looked after on the bench today by Malice. Just keep away from my bumps.
I have a slight pause to the start of the game here as we find out where our first aid people are. In order to run a game, we need someone dedicated at first aid.
So we are poised and ready to get underway.
I'm poised. Are you poised, Rob?
I am poised as.
I think our skaters are poised.
We're behind the camera. Nobody can see how poised we are.
No. The internet is poised. Our crowd here. Look at them. They're so poised.
Eurus is poised.
Big shout out to Eurus, who's watching us all the way from overseas. Big shout out to Dr. T as well. And all of our new fans on the internet. Game is now underway between the Pulp Vixens and Sisters of Anarchy.
Hangry Anderson is going to be doing the jamming for the Sisters straight up. Grenade O'Connor for the Vixens.
Whistles are getting blown. Looks like we've got a penalty for the Vixens.
And Grenade has ended up out of the pack first. Picks up the first lead jammer of the game for the Pulp Vixens. You see a little bit more pace in this version of Roller Derby, which is the full contact version of the flat track game, according to the WFTDA rules, not FIRS.
Grenade calling the jam off there and picking up some points from the Vixens. Waiting for that to be confirmed with our scoreboard.
Some points is the technical definition. Three. Saw these jammers go at it a little bit in the previous game as well. Oddsock Fitz and Brontosaurus Rex. Neither jammer yet making much progress through the pack. Some strong defense from both of these teams. So far already in the game, just up into jam two. And Rexy puts on a squirt of speed around the outside and lead once more for the Vixens.
She's come around and collect her points, and that she did, Rob, that she did.
In fact, that was all 5 points, still with the jammer in the pack. Problem trying to brewstering her way past those last nine defenders at the front, does so now. Takes a moment to catch up to the pack and pull the star cover onto the head.
Meanwhile, the Vixen hits the jam, pulls the jam off, adding 5 points to their score, giving them a lovely legs 11 number. That's a good number.
Watching us at home, huge thanks to Kilohertz for setting up the feed for us tonight. Currently scrambling around, having played in the last game that you didn't see on the internet.
Correct.
Fully into it now. Steel Thunder jamming for the Sisters of Anarchy. First time they've picked up lead. Great re-entry from Steel Thunder there as well. Just
Definitely
getting those hips directly behind the defender.
She's managed to put 5 in the sky for her team. The first 5 points that they've taken in this game.
And Grenade stashed the star cover, trying to sneak her way through the pack. Gets on out for an initial.
Again, she's meeting up with that amazing blocking butt of number. Pulling the jam off, Sisters now sitting at 9 points, and the Vixens are sitting on their perfection of a number 1-1.
So as we saw a nice close game in the last one, the Amber level scrim, and this one is shaping up to be just as close and just as exciting.
It's how you want your roller derby. You want it on quartz skates and close. And flat.
Hangry Anderson and Brontosaurus Rex jamming at the moment. Hangry has the front position on track at the moment, but fully engaged with those Vixens defenders.
Oh, I love this kind of derby where both jammers pop out the front together.
Looks like Hangry Anderson had just had the hips in front at the time, picks up lead and calls off the race.
2 leads apiece, Rob, 2 leads apiece.
It's how I like my Stevens.
Even.
Oddsock Fitz wearing the black and red star for the Sisters of Anarchy. Mad Scientist number 84 in the purple and white. Old Vixens, big hit at the front, and that last line of defence manages to keep her in the pack. Fitzy busts on out to pick up lead.
It's the kind of hit that gets you down the lead. This hit was done by number 301, Fizzy.
And Fitz just gets hit to the outside, pulls off the jam, sticks one on the board for the Sisters.
And bring us to a 1 point game.
In front of the line, just jockey for position, trying to get that front spot. They roll slowly back towards the jammers as the whistle goes. Steel Thunder jamming for the Sisters. Grenade O'Connor for the Vixens. Steel Thunder makes her way through the pack there as well. Looks like Mad Pixie might have picked up some friendly fire from one of her own players as part of that blocking.
It's okay, she recovered pretty well.
To get that hit on the next pass round, yeah.
Jam called off by the Sisters with 0-0 on the board.
So no change in the scores for that jam. Hangry Anderson, Brianosaurus Rex. Poised for the whistle. Rexy just given Hangry a little bit of a side eye as she makes her way up to the line.
She certainly did, with a gem of hesitation, they both
looked at
each other.
And Hangry able to step around Bella at the front there, picks up lead for the Sisters. Skate Princess just takes her out on the apex of 3 and 4, but goes out herself, so Rexy able to come back in without having a position.
Mary Anderson clear off the pack, putting points on the board for the Sisters.
Hangry looking to the bench for some guidance. She was ready to call it off, but called to keep going. Pack has an opportunity to reset. Hangry pulls that one off. Sisters have picked up the lead in this game now.
Just waiting for a score update. Picking up 5 points in that jam, the Sisters, and the Vixens picking up none, giving us a lead change. Sisters in front. Sorry, that's 9 points on the board for the Sisters. Giving us a lead change, 19-11.
Catitude Problem pulls on the staff of the Sisters this time round in the black and red. Hulk Vixens being jammed for by Grenade O'Connor, who indeed gets out first, passing that last blocker to pick up lead. Pack spreads out a little bit, they'll regroup down here around 3 or 4. Nearly 10 minutes played, we've had 8 jams, and the game is still close as Suz. Both teams yet to crack 20 points, so the defence as well as the jamming has been action-packed so far.
Yeah, they've only been putting a few points on the board each time. Very few multiple scoring passes have occurred.
Mary Poppins having another jam. Yeah, Brontosaurus Rex. For the Vixens, Bobs gets out first, picks up lead for the Sisters.
She certainly does.
Sisters in front on the lead jam account so far this game.
They are, 6 leads to the Vixens, 4.
Some of these skaters already having played a game prior to this one. Surely some fatigue and some fierce pushing on the inside there.
Very fierce pushing.
Hangry Anderson able to survive that push, get back in.
Penalty hitting for Vixen. Looks like the direction of gameplay. Yeah.
It ends up as a 4-point jam for the Pop Vixens. Brings them to within four. There's just one scoring pass in this game, Suz.
There certainly is.
Mad Scientist and Catitude Problem. Would be your jammers for Jam 11. Catitude, lead for the Sisters. Big hits there. Mad Scientist with the star in her hand, still being targeted. This time it's Catitude taken to the outside, has to go back a couple of spots and start that pass again. Off that jam. Yeah, it looks like, yeah, 5 points added to the Sisters. Takes them up to 28. Not yet at the halfway point of this period of play.
We've seen two penalties, both from the Vixens. No Sisters have entered the penalty box yet. They're keeping it pretty clean.
Looks like both jammers want to run up, approaching the line. And Brianosaurus Rex jamming for the Pulp Vixens. Gets pushed to the outside. Mary Boppins for the Sisters of Anarchy.
I've got my hands on the live chat here. So if you want to talk to me through the internet, people, you certainly can.
Bikini Killer Misery just taken, strung out of the front there. Have to let Pops go. She is the lead jammer for the Sisters. From her teammates to call that one off before the Vixens jammer hits the pack and pulls that one off. One more point added for the Sisters, none for the Vixens. Now we're at the halfway point. The jammers approaching the back of the jammer line. Grenada, Connor, and Hungry Anderson. An empty penalty box means that there's four blockers apiece in front of them. Side quickly engages with the back of the Vixens defense, but Grenada O'Connor, burst of speed down the inside, picks up a lead jammer for the Pulp Vixens. Still a struggle to get through this pack for Hungry Anderson. Grenada O'Connor on a scoring pass now, engages with the back of the pack, a strong triangular defense, anchored by Smacrobat at the front. Steel Thunder inserting herself in that Pulp Vixens triangle and allowing Henry Anderson to get clear of the pack. That's an initial for the Sisters. And O'Connor calls it off as she's taken to the outside of turn three. That jam puts more points on the board for the Pulp Vixens.
Certainly did, 3 points.
Jam 14 gets underway. Catitude Problem jamming for the Sisters. Cupquakes for the Vixens. Catitude. Receiving end of that hit. It's one of the key skills of this form of roller derby, though, is how quick you can get up from those hits and get back into your defence.
Absolutely.
And straight away from that big hit on this side of the track, she's chasing down the jammer at the front of the pack on the outside of the track. Katajit probably just receiving some instructions to call it. She does so. 3 points added to the sisters, and that stretches their lead out to 10 points. Cat and mouse, sirs.
Cat and mouse. It's like they're saying, baby sits, this and cheese. No, you can't.
Brionosaurus Rex and Henry Anderson, your jammers for this one. A strung out pack and a scrappy pack. As Brionosaurus Rex who gets out first. Bella just wrapping up that last defender, making that gap switch out too far, has to let her go. Angry Anderson gives chase. This pack hasn't got time to reset before these jammers are back amongst it. There's that much speed on these guys.
These jammers mean business. We've got a jammer lead ratio of 6 to 7. That's technically incorrect because I know I lost the jam somewhere. But we'll just go with that. My statistics are the only statistics, so hence the correct statistics.
Vixens. We've got 10 points on the scoreboard to make up. Oxo Fitz giving chase now. She's going to try and reel those points in. Grenade hits it and quits it, picks up the four, chipping away. Shaping up to be just the same. There is not much gap between these two teams in either skill level or performance or scores right now. Brionosaurus Rex and Steel Thunder. Both strong skaters, able to get some speed on. Rex, he does so around the outside, finds some clear air. He jammer for the Pump Fixers.
Currently the score for you at home is 32 to the sisters, 27.
Rexy breezes on pass for a 5-point scoring pass. Steel Thunder spins off a couple of hits there, gets clear of the pack. That's an initial for them.
That makes the scores even, 32-32.
And with that 4-point pass that Rexy just stuck on the board, that's going to be a lead change. Vixens are out in front now by 4.
They certainly are. 9 points in the jam.
As we go into a team timeout for the black team. For the folks at home, we've got 9.5 minutes left to play on the clock in the first period of this home team game between the Pulp Vixens and the Sisters of Anarchy. Sisters of Anarchy currently sitting on 32 points, the Vixens out in front on 36.
If you're here in the stadium, feel free to get yourself over to the bar, grab yourself a drink, and buy yourself a $1 ticket for the Rebels Fun Pack Raffle.
If you're at home, also buy a raffle ticket.
Yeah, so you can play at home. Just pick a number, any number. Not that number. That number's already taken. Or that number. Can't have that number either.
We're here at Friday Night Tides for Melbourne Northside Rollers, brought to you by Welcome to Thornbury and Nelson Alexander. And once again, we are collecting products and cash for the Melbourne Period Project. That's a great charity around Victoria that donates or collects and distributes tampons and pads and sanitary products to homeless and disadvantaged women and trans men all around the state. So get on board, bring your products down and put them in our buckets here at the Friday Night Tights events, or donate some cash in there as well.
Under 10 minutes left in the half.
Angry tangling up with Mad Pixie there. Both skaters back up again quickly and back into the battle to get out of the pack. Angry Anderson hangs onto that inside line by the skin of her skates.
That puts the Pulp Fixers up to 40 points, 4-0. We talked about this. It's what we call a blue church.
Sisters currently 8 behind on 32. Gets underway. Grenade O'Connor, Rodsock, Fitz doing the jamming duties. Fitzy's out first, picks up a lead for the sisters. And what's she going to do, Soz? She's going to chip away.
Chip, chip, chip. She's going to come through that pack. She's going to pick up those coins like she's playing Mario.
Into the pack, puts some speed. Side surfs around the outside of the last defenders, calls off the jam, picks up four for the sisters. Just being held as the goat behind the Vixens while we're behind and unable to join their defence.
Excellent foot there, by Rexy, as she's calling it, still trying to pick up points.
Just a couple for Rexy this time, taking 42.
We now have the Vixens topping the lead jammers with 10 leads to 9 on the sisters' side.
This time behind the line, Mad Scientist and Hangry Anderson. Hitting going on here, Hangry Anderson pops on out the front of that pack first as a lead jammer. There's a forearms penalty being assessed to Fitzgig. She'll head off to the penalty box.
That's our first sister in the box.
Side of the track calling off that jam.
It's the life of a pivot, isn't it? You grab a star, you put it on, you go around, and you get denied. Every time. Not at all speaking from experience, not at all
veteran. One in the box for the sisters. Jamming it up for the Vixens, now Grenade O'Connor, and for the sisters, Odd Sock Fitz. Nobody moving anywhere. Cat and Mouse.
Here's the cheese.
Little jammer hit out straight off the whistle.
No cheese for you.
Grenade's not going to play. Fitzy has successfully eaten the penalty. Looks for an inside run. Denied.
It looks like a jammer that just ate the penalty and then
gone. Tell you what, that was a turn of speed by Mad Pixie to get back behind her and force that cut. Which means that Grenade O'Connor comes out as lead jammer.
She certainly does rob. And with the other jammer sitting down for 30 seconds, let's see behind her once she can
run the ball. Grenade O'Connor just signalling to her defenders to move on up. Come in with a scattered offensive drive through that pack there at the moment. Grenade able to take advantage and take those blockers on one by one.
blockers were doing a good job of not allowing anyone to touch her.
Bumpy Skate Princess just took the chase down on Grenade there and took her out on turn two.
I think she just showed why she's called Bumpy Skate Princess.
She had to go a long way back.
Yeah.
At the end of that jam, we'll just wait to see which way the points fell from the jammer refs. Pop Vixens have ended up with three. They're out to 45. Sister Savannah Gee held the scores for that jam at 37.
According to my statistics, and we have established that my statistics are correct because they are there.
Only because we don't have any facts to back them up with.
That's correct. I'm still sitting on a 50-50 winning percentage for both teams. That could be wrong, but if it's wrong, I'm only out by one.
That's a fast jammer runs here at the moment. Steel Thunder chased down at the front and able to stand back up, picks up the lead.
The crowd here are going crazy. They're giving instructions to the jammers.
Both teams.
The jammers are just taking each other out.
Blocker a piece in the bin, so. In the back. There's offensive hits going on the blockers. Jam comes to an end, and the sisters come out with 2 points from that one. Still both teams with a blocker in the bin.
3-on-3.
Angry Anderson drops past on the inside.
She's angry.
She should get over to the bake sale.
She should. It would help her.
And does. Friendly fire tangle from the Pulp Fixers there as well. Some of those blockers taking each other out.
Lunch, dinner, movie. They're friends, they love each other. Score for you people on the internet, we're looking at 45 to the Pulp Fixers and 43 to the Sisters of Anarchy.
A minute and a half left to play in the first period. Brianosaurus Rex jamming for the Vixens now. Odds on Fitz for the Sisters. Vixens out first to pick up lead.
Rex. Sisters jammer picking up a cutting penalty issued there by the jam ref.
Rexy chucks it back a gear and accelerates around the track. Dodging around these skaters there now. Survives the outside push by Smackrobat. Picks up all five.
All five. You know where she puts them?
Sky to the ball. This time with the stepping around the line on the inside, surviving those hits. Five more.
These points are going to stick. They're never going to get them off.
This time, Bella giving her some offensive support in that triangle defense. She's pushed off to the inside. Calls it off. It's like another three. So it's a 13-point jam for Rexy. Takes the Pulp Fixins to 58.
It certainly does.
Sisters on 43. And the rolling whistle is going to take us into half time. So as we hit the half time break, those scores unchanged. 58 to 43 in favour of the Pulp Fixins. This is the Melbourne Northside Rollers Friday Night Tights home team games.
Coming to you live from Darrell and YMCA. Welcome to Thornbury, Nelson Alexander, and a big shout out to Eurus. We know you're watching us. We love you, we miss you, and when are you coming home?
Stick around, folks. There'll be heaps more roller derby still to come. If you're here in the venue, get on over to the bar and the bake sale. You've got this last opportunity to buy your raffle tickets for the Rebels. What do we call it? The Rebel Fun Pack. There's heaps of stuff in there provided by all the members of the Rebel Alliance. That'll be drawn real soon. In the meantime,
Sit back, relax.
Talk amongst yourselves.
Look at your Facebook feed.
We'll be back real soon. Breaking news, folks. I've just heard that the cafe outside in the foyer will be closing after half time. They've got a stock take to do. So if you want coffees and stuff, get like three or four now and line them up. White with two. You know what I really want, Suz?
You really, 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 really want to see us say, draw the Rebels raffle prize.
That's right. This is a Rebels care package. That's the official name for it. We call it the Rebels fun pack. It's packed with stuff from all the guys on the Rebels team. Pickled cherries, cookie butter, wine, chocolates. There's a cross-stitch in there.
Coffee.
Oh, that's lovely. Anyway, you guys have all been buying tickets, and we're about to draw them.
You certainly are. Get your tickets out. You know the rules at Roller Derby. If you buy a raffle ticket and you don't win, you have to eat the raffle ticket.
This time it's black tickets you're looking for. So if you've got any green ones left, chuck them away. They're for something else.
That's just my rule. I go by that rule. I live by that rule.
All right, I'm going to hold the hat nice up high. April's going to reach on in and pull out a ticket. If it's my ticket, that's really awkward. That's happened twice to me after my own ticket. It's a black ticket.
Black.
It's a black D.
D.
87.
D87, are you in the house?
Oh, everybody's frantically scrabbling through their pockets. Who's got D87? Is it a skater? They haven't even noticed because they've just got sweaty pockets and all of their raffle tickets are just mush now.
Could be an official. Oh, we're hearing calls for a redraw, D87. I've heard two calls for a redraw. I hear a third D87. We're going there. Oh, there's the third call. Redrawing once, redrawing twice, redraw.
Last chance for D87. All right, we're going to go for another ticket. Still going to be a black one. Don't look at those green tickets. And if you've got an orange ticket, that's probably left over from the footy. It's a black ticket. Black D.
Two fat ladies. 88. So who was after 87? Like, maybe your friends? Maybe you both got me up here. You left, didn't you? 86 and 87. Obviously people that don't hang around. Or that are in the toilet, so shh, I haven't joined them yet.
Okay. All right, so no takers for D87 or D88. We're gonna go again. April, reach on in there, dig deep. If you draw D89, I'm gonna kick you. This one's easy, it's got a name on it. It's a black ticket, D49.
He's in it for the cookie butter, people.
May or may not have already had some.
That was certainly day.
Woohoo! Congratulations, and thank you everybody who bought a ticket. That's going to help our Rebel Alliance team meet their travel commitments.
It certainly is. Thank you so much. Enjoy your cookie butter.
Come on, Billy.
And if you're still listening at home and that's not muted during the halftime break, thank you for listening to our raffle draw.
Yeah, thank you so much.
And
this is what you miss out.
New breaking news, we've got the scores on the screen. The technology works.
Technology is in the house. So 1 minute until we start the second half here, Rob. How do you feel about this next second half?
Well, at the moment I feel we've got scores on the screen. I won't have to say the scores so often, and I'm going to have to think of other stuff to say. It's been a close game. Pulp Vixens had the early advantage. The Sisters came back for a little while and had the lead. Vixens have grabbed it back and are taking the advantage into the second half.
Yeah.
Lead Jammers has been neck and neck, 12 and 13 in that first half.
We got penalties sitting at four for the Vixens and three for the Sisters, so even when they're not doing the right thing, they're doing it even.
Thank you. The skaters are poised, the officials are in position, we're just waiting for the rolling whistle. There it goes, Suz. Rolling whistle starts. Our timer.
You know what that means. It's time to start the jam.
Skaters are about to roll.
Yeah,
jam one of period two, half an hour left to play in this game.
Sisters taking the first lead for the second period. Angry Anderson, still hangry after the break. She didn't go to the bake sale, she missed out on the canteen. She didn't win the cookie butter, but she's gonna get some points. Excellent awareness by the Sisters Jammer. She looks back, she sees the Big Sisters Jammer approaching and decides, you know what? This is why I'm angry. He's picked up 2 points.
Bops is in the bin for the Sisters at the moment. Our jammers for the next jam are going to be Brontosaurus Rex and Steel Thunder.
I believe she started in the bin at the beginning of this half as a carryover from the last half.
Carryover bin champion.
We've all been there multiple times.
Rexy has taken to the inside, has to step back a little ways on the track, and this time
she gets hit out by Sisters blocker at the front of the pack. It was X. Sisters taking the lead.
Steel Thunder cleared the pack and was initially indicated as not lead, but
now she is.
Quick communication soon fixed that problem up. Tell you what, watching Steel Thunder, when she does get hit off the track, she is super quick to stop and turn around and get back into play.
Oh, she wastes no time. So 58 to 46, Sisters picking up 1 point. It's been slow point carnage. Actually, it's been no point carnage, really. Slow to pick up points, and like they're precious little diamonds.
Next jam is going to be between Grenade O'Connor and Cabitude Problem.
These blockers are not at all keen on giving up their points.
Cabitude has had some pretty good success today with getting lead, which on the few occasions she has jammed.
Smacker back in at the Vixens Jammer, a really nice hit out on the inside line. Business Jammer really thought she had that in way. Bomber doing the same to the Sisters.
Yeah, Grenade wrapped up on the outside again. Catitude taking these blockers out of the front, one to get past. Out of play at the front, Catitude Problem. Lead Jammer for the Sisters.
It is 58 to 57, 9 points put on the board by the Sisters. They have had 4 straight leads in a row. It is a nice tight close game.
Old Vixen's born. Bella Bomber. Out into the jammer rotation. So should be jamming for the Vixens, trying to pick up a lead and some points on the board for the Vixens in this half. And it's worked so far for them. That's the show's lead for the Vixens so far this half. Steel Thunder just switching it up around this triangular defense, trying to find a way past.
Stand focused.
On the outside, decides to call it off.
She certainly does.
Puts a couple more points on for that pass.
Oh, she got 6-4. That's excellent. Puts the Vixens in front by 3 points, leading 64-61. Now we know this jam could be pretty special coming up.
And the four whistles is going to put us into a timeout.
Jammers calculate exactly how many points they need.
Timeout over. Short timeout's a good timeout. Jam on, Grenade O'Connor and Kavachu problem. Stringing those blockers out of the front, down onto the knees, instantly back up again.
She's having to use brute force to get past them. But out of her core, instantly makes her lead.
And still that great record of lead jammer for Kavachu problem. Occasions that she's won the start today.
Very nice recycling by the sisters, blockers up front. One by one, then they all caught up with the triangle, holding the head back, but Grenade is out now. Sisters Jammer calls it, giving us another lead tune. 66-64. Still in the ballpark, guys. We can do this.
Rexy and Hangry. The Jammers trying to get us to our goals here at the moment. Rexy gets out first. But not legally, cutting the track as she does so. So one blocker in the bin for the sisters, one jammer in the bin for the Vixens.
This means this jam is going to go for a full 2 minutes. This is why my stats get ruined. I need a new column that says no jam, no lead jam. I'm going to make that column now.
The Hangry sits in the bin, Rexy gets out of the bin. Hangry only has to serve as much time as Rexy did. Only jam. We've got nearly a minute and a half left to skate in this jam.
For those of you at home, it is cold here. Like, it is cold. So when those skaters hit the floor, it is cold. I'm surprised they don't stick to it.
Yes, 4 points indicated by the jammer. For the pole, Vixens takes him to 68. From that one.
That's a shame, isn't it, Rob? Missed the mark, didn't they?
It's always a shame.
Always a shame when they get over that 70 mark.
This time, all 5 points picked up by Rexy. Jam is still at the back. Angry Anderson gets past those last defenders. 4 points for the sisters.
Nice one on the outside line there.
mark as well.
Some offense coming in from the Vixens.
Bella just heading off to the penalty box with forearms.
Yeah. That's giving the Vixens five penalties. It's just three. 85 to 74. We've got 21 points on the board there. 21. Sisters answering back with eight.
Even with a 5-3 penalty count, that is not a huge amount of penalties.
That's not a huge amount of penalties.
Well done, skaters.
I know. It's because they like each other. Because they're all going to go drinking after this. Welcome to Thornbury. Everyone wants to buy someone else to buy them a drink. Lovely walking there by Fizzy. I think they're cold on the floor, taking her out there.
Grenade puts on some speed around turn two, push to the outside. She has picked up lead. And Grenade just calling it off there. I'm not sure if she would have been in time.
I'm not quite sure. No, she don't think she was. It looks like we're getting 2 points up there on the board for the Sisters of Anarchy, taking them to a total of 76. So nice, two sneaky little 2 points. That's always a win when you don't get lead.
Oh, that correction to three. So there's a 77.
Even more reason to celebrate. Gemma's looking at each other, sussing each other out. Putting them back as hard as they can.
Tyrannosaurus Rex and catitude problem. Jammers currently battling their way through the pack. Tyrannosaurus Rex just having to come back in behind the blockers for the Sisters there.
Nice little 12. Picking up lead, Jammer, for the Sisters. I think my lead count keeps it watching.
And Tyrannosaurus Rex has ended up in the penalty box there as well. So Capitude not only picked up lead, also picked up a power jam. Problem heading off to the penalty box. Tyrannosaurus Rex already standing, so it'll be nearly a full penalty.
We're going for the full 2 minutes. We've got another minute on the game.
Tell you what, if you're on the edges of your seats here in the audience today, this game is being put up on YouTube. You'll be able to watch it again and again on the Northside Rollers YouTube channel.
More importantly, you'll be able to listen to us again and again.
Just turn the volume down. Another scoring pass. And Bella just with a jump over the apex there to get back in front of Kaju Problem. It's not able to hold it for long though. Trading scoring passes at the moment. Catitude just pushing past these blockers out at the front. The four whistles ends the jam, and it's always hard when it goes the full 2 minutes.
12 by 9.
The Pulp Vixens hanging onto that lead there at the moment. They're on 97, the Sisters on 86.
We've still got 16 minutes on the period clock, Rob. That's a lot of time.
That is a lot of minutes.
The jam starts with 8-4 on the jam line. First time you've seen 8-4 out tonight. Can't see her face, mad scientist. And we've got Hangry Anderson for the Sisters.
And Hangry manages to end up with Lee Jammer for the Sisters out first.
She certainly
Pixies. Mad Pixies ended up with the star on her head.
It's about time someone denied Mad Pixies some points.
He's just having a look. Looks like our scoreboard may have frozen here in the venue. I think we still have live scores going onto the YouTube feed. Oh, technical issues here at the Roller Derby.
Technical issues.
Have you tried restarting?
Try booting into safe mode.
Take the battery out, blow on it, stick it back in again. Maybe if you put the whole feed in the fridge overnight. Oh, then it will freeze again, that's a good point. You need to defrost it in the microwave.
Might have to restore your game from a backup.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, there's movement.
Just fixing the scoreboard back up here.
Yeah, looks like we've got the scoreboard running again. We'll just have to have a quick confab.
The opposite issue of what happened in the States on the weekend. So hot for them that their stream just melted.
I thought you were just going to say they had too many scoreboards.
No, that their stream just melted and that all of their equipment started failing. It's like really hot. They said it was 100 degrees. Now, I don't know what that means in Fahrenheit, but I think it's pretty hot.
I think it's pretty hot.
We've got the opposite here because it's so cold.
Similar thing happened at the AMRD Men's Nationals in Ipswich a couple of years ago. It got so hot that all the equipment overheated.
Yes.
Oh, the timer worked for a little while.
37. So 37 degrees in Portland. That would never happen in Australia. 37 degrees, we'd have what? So what?
It's just a Wednesday, isn't
Let's
it?
Let's go sunbaking.
Alright, we're back on board. 15 and a half minutes to play. 97 the Pulp Vixens, 91 Sisters of Anarchy.
That break in the game brought to you by our scoreboard. The rest of the games were brought to you by Robert Thornbury, Justin Alexander. And of course, also Rob.
Vixens blockers go out of play at the front, still Thunder.
Stealing
lead. See what I did there? I see what you did
there, Sam. Excuse me, Jeff. I just
like that now. Sisters picking up a couple of points out of that one. They're within 4 points.
Nice tight game, just over 14 minutes to go.
Scientist jamming for Vixens just gets taken out on the outside of turn two. So both jammers coming right back towards the jammer line to restart their entry into the pack.
Great blocking, great recycling.
Attitude wrapped up there at the moment.
Pixie out the front there. There's no Pixie. There's still Pixie blocking much. She loves to block in these home team games.
Triangle of offense.
Yeah.
both exit the track together and come back in.
Kat decided, you know what, she's had enough. She's gone back to the bench. She's gone girl. She gets control. She earned lead.
Couple of points in that one for the sisters. Brings them up to within two.
That was a big, long, hard fight for those 2 points, just to show you how hard it is out there on the track.
Jam 12 now of the second period of this home team's game, Pulp Vixens and Sisters of Anarchy. Here we go for the Sisters. Angry Anderson gets out first to be lead jammer. Scoring pass. Sisters of Anarchy not only take the lead, but they also hit the hunge.
They hit the hungy.
They crack a ton.
One sister connected to the box. Smiling assassins of Angry Anderson. Always a smile on the face. They all want
way down there at the back. Bunch of skaters go down. Granada kind of takes the opportunity to get past and gets cleaned up on the inside. Again, she said that's enough.
Angry Anderson put 14 points on the board for her team, giving them a lead change and a little bit of a 10-point buffer with 10 minutes on the clock.
Yeah, another four out of there, so it's 18 points that last jam.
Oh, acing! Unbelievable.
So the penalty box is cleaned again. Steel, Thunder, and Rexy.
Hey, Melons. Hey, Melons. So Vixen's picking up the lovely Rexy.
Rexy will be trying to take this or meet up this gap there. Just leaves a couple of blockers in her wake. Steel Thunder out of the pack, giving her Rexy a bit of a touch up on the way past turns three and four.
Calling the jam off.
Rexy's going to hit the hunge and call that one off. Take four for that one for the Vixens.
Narrowing that gap down, 102-111.
Inside the last 10 minutes now, it's still
anyone's game.
I wasn't going to say that.
Oh, yeah?
I was trying not to. I was thinking really close. It's still really close. That's one of those announcer bingo phrases.
The sister heading to the penalty box.
And Pixie just bringing Fitzy back as far as possible. And just on the outside, Cupquake's jamming for the Pulp Vixens. Take it to the
doing his signature move there.
Taking to the outside of two. Pixie coming in with the offence and gets Quakes out for lead. This time opening up the centre.
Yes, I was about to say, great offence by Bikini Kill. Get the jammer through. Seeing some point movement on the board now. Pulp Vixens picking up 4 points. Great offense. They're really the blockers fans. That jam, I think. I like to dedicate that jam to Vixens blockers.
Lexi just taking advantage of that 30 seconds. Changeover top of the dance behind the jammer line. Angry Anderson jamming for the sisters. But it's Rexy who's out first. Angry Anderson just getting pummeled by those Vixens blockers at the front. And haven't the Vixens blockers really picked up just in the last two or three games? They've really intensified their offense. Now on the scoreboard, folks, 111 apiece for these teams. Vixens would have just picked up the lead with that last pass from Rexy, too.
I think that bench coach has had a word. The bench coach had an arm off. She said, go out, get me those points, then come back to the bench.
Sisters have completed a star pass off to Fizgig.
Fizgig very happy to put that on.
Yeah, so as Rex says, no more. I'll even chuck a couple more on the point on the board for good luck.
We're looking at another lead change, 120 to 111. 6 minutes 40 on the clock. By the time the next jam clock starts, it'll be 30 seconds from that time. Still 6 minutes late. Vixens are keen, they're up. They're like, oh, I'm on the break.
Well, she's having a chat to the officials and she's going to call a team timeout. So to recap, just under 6.5 minutes left to play in the second period of this game. Pulp Vixens with the lead, 120 over the Sisters of Anarchy, 111.
I could give you some statistics, Rob, but I think they're wrong now. I looked away too much. But I would say with penalties, we're looking pretty even. 6-6, according to my calculations. Lead, I think the Sisters have held lead a little bit, a few more times, because they've been able to claw back that point differential. Vixens have been able to really kind of get some really good points on the board when they've had lead, which has really held them up there. Because according to my league count, we've got 10 for the Sisters and 6 for the Vixens, but I think that might be technically incorrect. But roughly correct.
Roughly correct, except for the facts.
Yes, except for the facts of life.
Heard his rolling whistle, we'll start the timer again. Into the 30 seconds before the next jam begins. Coiled like a spring behind the jammer line, Grenade O'Connor and Steel Thunder. No blockers in the bin. It's 4-on-4 in front of the line.
It's gonna get exciting.
Thought she'd come out first, but she's just been pushed off on the inside. She has to go way back and start that pass again.
These blockers will be really trying hard to get their own jammer lead, concentrating and holding that other jammer down as long and as hard as they can.
Grenade O'Connor, lead jammer for the Pulp Vixens. So those Vixens blockers roll around in front. This time put the sneaky star pass off. Fizgig is pulling the star back on again. She don't need that giver cover.
She doesn't, that's her signature move. She just pulls that off, throws that to the bench. She's like, I don't need that anymore. I'm the jam now.
Somebody go pick that up.
Because I'm busy.
Five and a half minutes left to play. Pulp Vixens have extended that lead a tiny little bit more. 124.
Sisters will be looking for lead, they'll be looking for hopefully power jam. They're looking to win. Hear the crowd yelling instructions.
Of course, Stars, as we all know, at the end of the day, the team with the most points at the end of play is declared the winner.
That is correct.
And Fitzy picks up lead for the Sisters.
You probably heard me. They need this lead, the Sisters. 4 minutes of gameplay left.
At first she's got this purple and white triangle to get past at the back.
Sisters walk ahead into the penalty box for a 4-ups penalty.
Mad scientist on the receiving end of that. She is the jammer for the Vixens. Currently wrapped up by these couple of strong blockers at the front.
Great blocking lineups out there. Working on
Fitzy's been
smart.
Bitsy's been taken off and recycled way back by Mad Pixie. And that's just slowed the play down. It's given these defensive formations time to reform in front of both of these jammers.
The star from her jammer at the end of that jam, but the sisters jammer calling off the jam.
Yeah, Fitzy just calling that off. You probably heard it at home. Fizgig was calling out to get me out of the bed.
Yes, she was. She was standing, which means she's got under 10 seconds to serve.
3.5 minutes left to play. There's only 9 points in this game, Suz.
There is, Rob. There is. And you know how that makes me feel. I'm excited.
And sisters with lead again. Hangry Anderson stretches those legs and gets out of the pack.
Proving she's angry enough for it.
And look at this pack go. They've reset now. They took off, but they've re-solidified. Hangry gets her round, whacks the hips, calls it off. How many she's put on there? A couple.
She's put two on the board, I think, the jammer ref is putting in the air.
Importantly, held the Vixens to nil.
Fantastic work by Hangry. Fantastic work by everyone. That Vixen's jammer was hot on her tail, forced her to call, only allowed her to pick up two. That's a win. The sisters are celebrating too.
Renee O'Connor and Katachu problem. Katachu just gives Grenade a bit of a shove to the inside off the line there. Just feeds her into the defence. Nobody yet to pop one through. Katachu strong-arming her way past these defenders at the front. Lays one down, lays another down. They have to let her go. They're out of play.
Out of play. Stiffly ball. Makes her lead number. We've got a Vixen heading to the ball. It's from a shooting arrow.
Now a sister's blocker heading off to the penalty box as well.
This is where you see blockers going in and out of that box because it's about putting your body on the line, trying to extend yourself.
Inside the last 2 minutes now, and Katachu problem has brought the sisters to within 2 points.
Crowd is going off. Sisters fans are losing it. The Vixens fans are losing it. I'm just keeping myself together.
And another 5 point scoring pass takes the sisters to the lead of this game, 127 over 124. And looks like we've had a Vixen's star pass. Mad Pixie accelerating away from the pack, doing something with her head. It looks like pulling a star onto it. And Mad Pixie comes in with some pace into that one.
I've got news, Rob. I've got news.
Oh, I think I know what the news is.
I'm going to wait till the skaters work out the news. Because we can't call things the skaters don't know. They've worked it out. Sisters jammer just went to the penalty box.
And Mad Pixie just got the Vixens back in front by one.
Of all jammers, do not want wearing the star right now. It's Mad Pixie.
Jam time's going to run out. 37 seconds.
The jam is called.
So 5 more points added at the end of that one. Pulp Vixens go to 133. The sisters of Anarchy are on 129. And would you believe we've got a team timeout, Suz?
I believe it. I believe it because I just saw it. I just saw both benches go for it. I don't understand why one bench would have gone for it, but both went for it.
So what that means, folks, is that we are going to have another jam.
So if the period clock is under 30 seconds, there hence cannot be 30 seconds between jams, hence there cannot be another jam unless one team calls a timeout. In this instance, it is in the best interest of one team to call a timeout, not in the best interest of another. Timeout has been called. We've got another jam. This is it.
We've got a jammer in the bin.
Question is,
everyone can see how long she's got left.
So many strategic decisions would have been made on the bench of the sisters right now. One of them will be who's going to put a strike. So
it's all about to come down to this folks, the rolling whistle has sounded. We've got 30 seconds for the skaters to reform on track before the what is possibly the last jam of the game.
We could possibly be the last jam. We still have a few timeouts up our sleeve. We could see another jam. This could be it, folks. Let's hear it for the Sisters of Anarchy and the Pulp Vixens.
Number 101, Brionosaurus Rex, is going to be taking the jam for the Vixens.
Vixens starting on the line, unopposed by the Sisters jammer.
So the Sisters Blubbers will be trying to contain her at the moment. So she's busted out the front of the pack to be lead.
She certainly has.
And is back amongst the scoring pass there now. Picks up the points. She will get all five for that one. There's a jammer point involved there as well. Looking to the bench for instructions.
And the jammer reluctantly takes the call from the bench to call the jam. The period clock is out. The bench made the right call there, ensuring that the Pulp Vixens lead with 138-129 as the unofficial score.
So as the jammer refs go and confirm the scores, make sure everything's in order. The rolling whistle will make it final once that happens. It's official, folks. The Pulp Vixens take the win over the Sisters of Anarchy. In a hard-fought game, there was just as much decided by the strength of the blockers as it was by the speed and the agility of the jammers.
Oh, the commentary team. I think we had a lot to do with that game's results.
So once again, folks, get down trackside. Get your high fives ready for these sweaty skaters to come on round. Your runners-up today, the Sisters of Anarchy, were X, Hangry Anderson, Fizgig, Mary Boppins, Catitude Problem, Steel Thunder, Odd Sock Fitz, Smackrobat, Bumpy Skate Princess, and on the bench was Malice. But your victors today, taking out the win, the Pulp Vixens, Brionosaurus Rex, Grenade O'Connor, Misery, Bella, Mad Pixie, Mad Scientist, Venus Thighslap, KO, and Cupquakes.
We'd like to thank, welcome to Thornbury, Nelson Alexander. We've came to you live from Durban YMCA for Northside Rollers Friday Night Tights. We're hoping to make this streaming thing a thing. So please subscribe to our YouTube page. Love the roller derby.
And keep an eye out for all of the roller derby coming up in the near future. Check out the Facebook pages of all your favourite leagues. And keep up to date with when you can come and check out the roller derby in person. I've been Bob DeQuickly.
I've been Suspender. It's been a pleasure, Rob.
Thank you.